Hi, Jason with Tormach. We've got a tooling video for you guys today. Thanks for coming and checking it out. We're going to talk about our DIJET cutter. We have a DIJET high feed style end mill that we can use with our modular TTS tooling. So let's dive into this thing and see what kind of capabilities and how to utilize this tool. Here it is. It's this little, it's a half inch diameter, three flute high feed style end mill. So what's a high feed end mill? It's a tool that's designed to reduce the engagement angle of the material in the cutter. So it thins the chips out very efficiently. This reduces cutting forces and allows us to just turn up the feed rates. They're really fun to use. On this little half inch cutter, we can run chip loads all the way up to about 15 thousandths of an inch per tooth, which is just insane. Super fun. And it does this all through hardened materials as well. So you can see it's a modular style cutting head. So we can fit it onto any of our three different lengths of 6 millimeters. So this is an M6 holder. So we have a short, a medium, and a long. You can see this one's currently mated up with the short holder. You know, you just, as always, keep your tools as short as possible, but when you need the really long tool, you'll see in some of the cutting footage that we're gonna run through that we're gonna use the long holder, and we're gonna, you know, lean on these things and test them in all the different scenarios. We kind of got some fun tests for you guys lined up. I've got some 1-2-3 blocks. I've got some hardened vise jaws. Both of those are about a 60 Rockwell C. I've got some pre-hardened chromoly, some 4140. We've got some stainless steel. We've got some mild steel. I'm just trying to run these things through the paces and see how they perform. So we've got three main types of inserts available for this cutter. As I mentioned, this is a high feed style cutter. It's the reason why we have it, but they also offer a traditional style insert for it where it's just gonna do shoulder milling. So that's this insert here. The naming structure starts with a Z. So anything with a Z at the beginning, this is gonna be your standard traditional shoulder milling style insert. For this kind of testing and stuff, this isn't why we have this cutter. This isn't the stuff we want to explore and test with it today. But I just wanted to let you guys know that if you need a shoulder insert for this cutter, it is available. The other two types that we have, it really differentiates between them between materials. So we have an insert that's for 50 Rockwell and up, and we have the insert that's for less than 50 Rockwell. And then there's a couple flavors of each as we go. We'll start with the inserts that are for the softer material, anything under 50 Rockwell C. These inserts are going to start with an E. So on this specific one, we have an E0 or EOMT. So what does that mean? The T is the chip breaker. So this insert's going to have a little more defined chip breaker on it. It's going to work really well for really long tooling, for stainless steels, gummy materials. It just reduces your cutting force. So it's good in all those scenarios. It makes the insert a little less durable, but it also makes it work in a little more difficult scenarios as well. This is kind of going to be your general purpose insert. So if you're just cutting 4140s, stainless steels and stuff like that, this is kind of the insert you don't want to have around just as your kind of go-to insert. The second one that we have for the softer materials is going to be this EOMW. And the W is for unfavorable conditions. So if we're going to do interrupted cutting, if we have scale or heat treat scale or just, you know, any conditions that you're looking at your part and you're like, man, this is going to be really hard on tooling, you're going to want to switch to the W style. It's just going to be a more durable edge on the insert. As you can see, we cut up a 1-2-3 block. This was about the worst scenario I could think of as far as materials and stuff I had laying around the shop. This is about 60 Rockwell C and it's interrupted cutting. It's very hard on your tooling. So again, that's the EMOWs for your unfavorable or your the harder to machine conditions. When we get to hard materials, we have the EOHWs. So the H is for hard, and then these are all going to be that W style. They don't offer that chip breaker for the high heat, for the high temperature coatings and stuff. So when we look up at this insert, you can see that the shape of the insert and everything, this thing's pretty much solid and straight. There's no chip breaker on it. It's designed to handle that really high temperature you get from machining hardened steels. There are some considerations you need to keep in mind when you're using a high feed style cutter. These are designed to be used to exploit chip thinning. So they are designed for really light depths of cut. These are really small inserts on this cutter. These are a very small three flute on a half inch cutter. The maximum depth of cut you'd want to take with this cutter would be about 15 thousandths of an inch. Realistically, when you program this, if you want to get good tool life, not really have to worry about the inserts failing prematurely. If you stick with that 10 to 12,000 depth of cut, you just get really good tool life. They hold up well. If you overload them a little bit in corners or something, they don't pop an insert. So we just found that running them at that 10 to 12,000 depth of cut, they just last a lot longer. And then your chip load. Your chip load's gonna be pretty consistent from material to material on these. So again, the recommended, like where we like to see these start out, is that 10 to 12,000 per tooth. You can push them up a little bit higher than that, but again, you start getting into that, you're pushing the limit, you can start to see the inserts fail a little prematurely. You can definitely run them there if your machine sounds good and everything's running well, you know, you're not gonna hurt it, but if a good starting point is that 10 to 12,000 per tooth. And then surface footages and stuff like that, these get really high. On a pre-hardened block of 4140, we can run surface footages up to about 500 on a piece of hardened steel, which is amazingly fast. So we'll get into this a little more specifics on each kind of material as we work through them in all the cutting. I'm excited to get this thing running and get some more chips flying off of it. So let's just jump into the cutting here and we'll work through some of the recipes.
All right, so this is a 1-2-3 block. We put this on the hardness tester and it came up to be about a 58 to a 60 Rockwell. The inserts I started with were just the standard EMOTs, so they're inserts for the softer material. I had them in the cutter, I just kind of wanted to try it out and see how it would work. As you can see, when it's cutting through this material, there's quite a bit of sparks. It's definitely the wrong insert. We did wear the inserts out in the two passes that we took with it, but as I mentioned, it's just something we wanted to try out and test to see what kind of tool life we would get. So here we switched to the appropriate insert for this material. It's the EOHW. So this is for the hard materials, you know, the 50 plus Rockwells. We're running this cutter at about 400 surface footage at a 10th hour depth of cut and a 10th hour chip. As you can hear on this cutting, it is a pretty aggressive cut. I was trying to find a really, you know, basically a terrible cutting scenario for this cutter. So this is a high hardness, high interruption. You can hear the machine loading and unloading as it's cutting. The video actually makes it sound a little worse than it does in life. It was definitely an aggressive cutting. This program was just done in the conversational in-path pilot, so something we just wanted to try out quick and dirty. You can see the surface finish here. It actually looks pretty nice for a roughing tool. A lot of times with a cutter like this, you'll get some really aggressive feed rates, which give you a really aggressive, you know, really rough surface finish. But this actually looks pretty nice when it's finished. This is a block of 4140 pre-hard. Those come in at about a 28 to a 32 Rockwell C. We're just doing a little bit of kind of 3D profiling, roughing on this. You can see on the tool path here, it leaves some islands. So when I defined the tool in cam, I didn't quite have the diameters and stuff set right. I just kind of decided to leave it a little bit higher load, a little bit overloading scenario, just to kind of see how the cutter would handle it. So not an ideal tool path, but we just left it to see how it would do. You can see in some of these slow-mo clips here that you can actually see these chips coming off brown, and then they're kind of half brown, half blue. So we know we had our surface footage dialed in pretty well with this one. We were running this at about 500 surface footage at that same 10th thou depth of cut and 10th thou chip load. On the ramping here on the circle and the slot, we did slow down the feed rates a little bit just to free up some horsepower and allow the machine to work. This is a hardened steel vise jaw that we had. This is also about a 58 to 60 Rockwell. For this cutter, we left the same inserts in, so we're still running the hardened inserts here. We ran this at 400 surface footage as well. You can hear on this, it sounds a lot nicer than that 1-2-3 block does. It has a lot more consistent loading on the tool without all the interruptions. You know, then as I mentioned, we ran this about 400 surface footage, kind of your starting point for a hardened material like this. You'd want to be in that 300 to 400 surface footage range. It's a good place to start. And with all these cuts, we're just running the fog buster with the coolant turned off. So all these are just using an air blast to clear chips. This footage here is from our quadcopter project that we had previously done. So this was in 304 stainless. So this was about 325 surface footage at 10th out depth and a 10th out chip again. And we roughed out two different mold halves on this. We had almost 3 hours of cut life on these inserts and they were, you know, still looking pretty strong at the end of the cutting. These were the EMOTs, so these were the chip breaker insert that is designed for those gummy stainless steels and lower cutting forces. We chose to run flood coolant on the stainless just to help with heat management. We really didn't want to heat up this part too much and cause the work hardening to happen. So we did run flood coolant. You can see it just has its own challenges. You need quite a bit of flood coolant to flush parts out of over an inch deep pocket when you're making chips as fast as you are with this DIJET cutter. This footage here, this is just a block of 1018 mild steel we had. It's just a 3-inch round. I just wanted to do some aggressive ramping. So this was just kind of a little bit of play session. You can see we're in the real long extended holder here. We ran this about 350 surface footage at 10 thou tooth, and we did 10 thousandths per revolution on the ramp angle here just to keep the cutter at that light depth of cut. But we were able to run this very fast. We were running this right around 90 inches a minute. And as you can hear, it sounds really nice while it's working through this material. Definitely got some chip management concerns and troubleshooting to do here. It's a couple inch deep pocket that we're going through, so just got to blow the chips out of the bottom. So it is using dual fog buster nozzles for chip clearing. So kind of just to summarize what you guys have seen here is we've cut everything from mild steel, some stainless steels, we've cut some hardened steels, some alloy hardened steels. This cutter is very capable. It works through a wide array of different materials. It performs very well. It's very efficient at removing material. We'll have a link in the video description below for specifics on what inserts are for what materials with part numbers and everything for you guys to make it easy.
So thanks for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed this overview video on the DIJET High Feed Mill. As I mentioned, they're super fun. Pick one up, try it out, have fun with it. Feel free to check out our other YouTube videos here and subscribe to our YouTube channel here.